Hey there guys, it's Fuzzy here, and today I will be showing you guys how to make a simple wooden starter house. This is the first tutorial on our channel, so if you guys enjoy this video, then make sure to drop a like, subscribe to the channel, and comment down below. Anyways, let's get into the tutorial. Alright, so here is the general layout of the build. We have some red and white wool outlining the entire perimeter, and we have some light blue wool marking where the stairs are going to be. Here is the palette for the build. As you can see, we're using a lot of spruce logs, spruce planks, some trap doors, oak for the walls. We also have some campfires, fence and fence gates, some stripped birch wood for the roofing, and lecterns for the railing. So let's get started and take our spruce log and place one spruce log 1, 2, 3, 4 blocks tall. We're gonna have a 3-block gap to the left, so 1, 2, 3, connect them with spruce logs. Then we're gonna go on this 4th block, 1, 2, 3, 4, make sure it is flush with the first log you just placed. Now we're gonna go back 3, so 1, 2, 3, place 1, 2, 3, 4 high pillar, 4, and connect them. Now we are going to go back 3 more, so make sure there's another 3-block gap between these pillars, and then go 1, 2, 3, 4, connect them. And we're just gonna go another 3-block gap, so 1, 2, 3, and then 1, 2, 3, 4. Now we're gonna finish off this rectangle and just connect these logs. And when you're done, you should have a 5x9 rectangle. Now we're gonna go right of the rectangle we just made. We're gonna go 2 blocks, and then on the 3rd block, you're gonna place 1 spruce log. Remember to be flush with the rectangle. Next, we're gonna go 1 block forward and place 1, 2 logs. Now we're gonna go 1, 2, 3 up with 1 block forward. Another block forward, we're gonna go 4 high, and then another block forward, we're still gonna go 4 high. So you should make something like this. Now this is gonna be our stairs, so we're going to take our spruce stairs next, and we're just gonna place them, matching them up with the heights of these logs that we just made. We'll also connect these two right here. Now we're gonna focus on the right side, so we're gonna go from the stair blocks. We're gonna go 1, 2, 3, and then on the 4th block, we're gonna place another 4 high pillar. We're gonna go back 3, so 1, 2, 3, and then on the 4th block, we're gonna place another 4 high pillar, another 3 blocks wide, and then a 4 block pillar. We're gonna go left if you're facing this way, another 3 blocks, so 1, 2, 3, and then we're gonna go up 4 on this pillar. So for this one, you're gonna go left 2 blocks, so a 2 block gap, and then on the 3rd block this time, we're gonna go 4 high, and then we're just gonna connect them, and they should match up just like this. So once we have this, we are also going to go to this bigger square right here, and we're just gonna cut it in half with a spruce log like so, like that. And we're also gonna go over to and match a log up with this one in the back. So we're just gonna place a 4 high log like that. Next, we're going to take our spruce slabs and place them as the floor. And we're just gonna fill in these little rectangles and squares with spruce slabs. Once you're done with spruce slabs, it should look like this. And now we are going to focus on the bottom of the build. We're gonna take our spruce stairs and our spruce trap doors. We're gonna go up right next to the stairs to the left, and in this 3x3 gap, we're going to place one spruce stair and another spruce stair upside down like that. We're gonna take our spruce trap doors, place one in the middle, and then place two on either side of these logs. Now we're going to go around the entire perimeter and place this upside down stair and trap door pattern on every one of them, except don't place these spruce trap doors for now. So we're gonna go around and just place these spruce trap doors with the upside down stairs all around the entire perimeter only, not on the bottom, like inside here. We're only gonna place them outside like this. And once you get to this 2-block gap, you're just gonna place one spruce stair and another spruce stair upside down, like so. No trap doors in that 2x1 gap, but we're just gonna keep going around the perimeter and filling in these upside down stairs and spruce trap doors. And you should come out like that. So for the bottom, we are going to place our oak fence and oak fence gates. We're going to come down here, and in this little back section, right here, this little back section. We're gonna go under it and place some oak fence to the right and left. We're gonna take our gate and place it in the middle. For this two block gap, we're just gonna place two oak fence. And then around it, we're just gonna place our oak fences all around like so. And it should look something like this. Next, we're also gonna place a little chicken coop. So we're going to go one, two on the sides, and then an oak fence. It should line up and be flush with this staircase right here. We're gonna go in, and then we're going to do something special on this. But for this side, we're going to place two oak fences on either side, right and left, and then take our oak fence gate and place it in the middle, just so we can have access on both sides, whichever way we walk through. So we're going to come over to our staircase now and place our oak planks. We're going to make sure that they're flush with these logs, so we're just going to place them right next to the stairs like this. Go into this little chicken coop that we're going to have and place them flush, like so. We're going to come out and make a door. First, before we make the door, we're going to take our spruce planks and just place it underneath the stairs and make it like a little flooring area. Next, we're going to place our door, and we're going to go in and take some barrels. And then we're just going to place them in a staircase formation like this, and maybe even one right there. Next, to add another finishing touch, we're just going to place a lantern right to the left so we can have some light when we're going into our storage closet for our animals. Next, we're going to spawn in our animals. I'm just going to take some chickens and place them here. Maybe four chickens are good. Make sure they don't get out, by the way. And then our bigger cow pen, we're just going to place a few cows, maybe one, two, three, four, same as the chicken coop. I'm just going to close them in, and you have your little farm for your survival base. So we're going to take our lanterns and place a slab in this corner, a lantern right there. We're also going to place a slab in the other corner, a lantern right there. We're going to go into the chicken coop, not let any chickens out, go through it. I'm going to come to this corner and place a spruce slab and a lantern right there. Next, we are going to go into the cow pen, you know, give them some light. So we're going to come over to this corner and place a spruce slab and a lantern and a spruce slab and a lantern. Now it should be all lit up, so we won't have to worry about anything spawning down there. Now the last part we are going to do on this bottom part is to put spruce trap doors on this side right here. We're gonna move over to this little indent and place some more spruce trap doors, and we're also gonna place some more spruce trap doors right here. You also don't put any spruce trapdoors where there are fence already placed, so don't worry about those. We're gonna come over to the right side of the build and just place some more spruce trapdoors on this right part and on this part right here. So it should look like this. Now that we're done with the bottom, we will move on to the top. So we're going to go onto this platform that we made, and we're gonna go right next to the stairs to the left, and we're gonna place 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 tall, and we're gonna connect them with 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 on the left. Make a 3-block wide gap, go back 3 blocks, and then on the fourth we're gonna place 5 high. We're just gonna continue this all over to here, and we're gonna make a rectangle that we made, the same rectangle that we made in the start of the bottom of the base. So once you're done making that little rectangle, we're gonna move on to the back. We have these logs conveniently marked out for us, so we're just gonna go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 this time in this little area right here. And then we're gonna take our top right log in our rectangle, and we're gonna go up 3 more, 1, 2, 3, and they should match up perfectly. Now we're going to connect them and then go back and go 1, 2, 3 in the back. Next we're going to go up 8 in this back part right here. Connect them with 2 logs, and then we're going to go 8 up again. And we're just going to finish off this little rectangle right here. Next we're going to move on to the right side. So we're going to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 on this right side. And then go 1, 2, 3 blocks back. On the 4th block we're going to go 5 up again. And then we're going to connect this with being flush to the logs that you just placed. So just like this. Now we are going to take our oak planks and just fill in the walls. We're just going to go around the entire perimeter of the base. We're going to fill in these little areas, these 3x3s and these 2x however tall this is. We're also just gonna go all the way around the perimeter and fill in these oak planks. So when we finish filling the logs, it should look something like this. I'll just give you guys a quick fly around just to show you guys everything. And one more thing I forgot to fill in was here. So I'm just going to fill in this area right here. And remember to stop in this area at these logs and just break this and place some logs right here. So it should look like this. Now we will focus on the roof. So I will take my spruce stairs and come over to this left area right here. And we're just going to place spruce stairs all along this side like that. And we're going to give it a little overhang, so put another stair. We are also going to go on this outside area and place spruce stairs all along this structure like this. And then we're going to give it a overhang on both sides this time because there's no tower blocking it. Next, we're going to place upside down stairs and upside down stairs both on either side like that. Then we're going to place a slab on top and a slab on top, another slab right next to it, and then another slab right on top of that slab. Next, we're going to take two spruce stairs and place them like this. Now for our finishing touch, we're going to take our stripped spruce log, add a placeholder block right here, and put a stripped spruce log right here so the texture is showing. Next, we'll come over, remove the placeholder block, and place another stripped spruce right there. We'll also need to fill in this gap, so let's just put a oak plank right in the center of there. Next, we'll come over to the backside and place one spruce stair like this, upside down, and then we'll place a slab on top. Place another slab to the left of it, and then another slab at the top. We're gonna take our spruce stairs and place another one like so. Next, we'll take a stripped spruce log, put a placeholder block, and make sure the texture is showing. Break the placeholder block and put another stripped spruce there. We'll put a spruce stair right next to the stripped spruce, and then we'll take one plank or two slabs and place it right under that stair we just placed. Next, we'll take oak planks and fill in the gap, and then we'll come over to this side and take our stripped birch wood and just fill in this entire roof. So once you finish the entire roof, you're going to leave this top part open, and we're going to take our spruce slabs and place one right on top of the second stripped spruce. Make sure one of the stripped spruce logs is jutting out. We're going to take this spruce slab and run it all along the top of the roof. All right, so now that we're done with this roof, we are going to focus on the tower roof now. We're gonna take our spruce stairs and place them all along this line right here. And we're gonna come over to the other side and do the same exact thing. We're also gonna give it a overhang, so we're gonna go out one block on each side. Next, we're going to take upside down stairs and place them like this. Another upside down stairs. We're going for an A-frame roof, so we're gonna keep alternating between upside down stair and right side up stair. We're also gonna take some spruce slabs at the top and place two like this. Next, we're gonna cover in this little gap area with two oak planks, and we'll mirror this on this side. Once we have done the frame of the roof on both sides, we are going to take our stripped birch wood and just place it along like this. We're just going to cover in the entire roof with stripped birch wood. Now we will move on to the right side, where we will put spruce stairs along like this, making sure to stop at the tower, or the middle tower right here. We also want to give it an overhang and go to the other side and do the same thing. Make sure to stop at this log of the tower and give it a overhang like that. Next, we will put a spruce stair upside down like this on either side, a slab on top of those, another slab right next to them, and another slab on top. We're going to also finish up with one last slab like this. We're going to take our oak planks and just place it in this gap. Next, we're going to fill in this roof, but this time we're going to use a pattern of birch slabs and stripped birch wood. So we're going to take our birch slabs and place them like this along the first layer. Next, we're going to take our stripped birch wood and place it on the same layer as the birch slab, but it should still be showing because it's a full block and not a slab. Next, we will take our birch slab and place it right above the stripped birch wood. We're just going to do this alternating pattern of birch slab and stripped birch wood all over this roof like this. So now we will focus on the doors. We're going to make a door right here where the stairs are located, and then we're going to make another door to the left, which is a one block door like this. We're also going to make some windows, so we're going to put a window right here, which is a 1x1 window right next to the 2x2 door. We're also going to make another window right next to the left door. Next, we're going to make a window on this left side like this, which is a 2x1. We're also going to come over to this side and make a window like this. Make it on the left side, not the right. We're not going to put anything on the right. We're going to come to the back and place two windows like this. And then we're not going to make a window on this 2x2 tower. We're going to put one to the left. And we're going to put one more right here. The next step is to take our white stained glass panes and fill in all the gaps where we made our window holes. Once we are done with that, we are going to focus on the little designs on top of the windows. So we're going to take our campfire blocks and our spruce fence gates. We're also going to take a shovel, and we're going to place a campfire right on top of this window. We're going to put it out, and then we're going to place a spruce fence gate right under the campfire and open it. We're going to do that on every single window. So every single window you see is a campfire on top, put it out, and then a spruce fence gate right on the bottom. Except this window right here, where we will put a balcony later. And then once you're done with that, let's make the little balcony area. So we're gonna take our spruce logs. We're gonna go from this corner. We're gonna go 1, 2, 3 blocks tall. We're also gonna go 3 over right next to the staircase. We're gonna go 1, 2, 3 again. We're going to place placeholder blocks right here. Then we're gonna take our spruce trap doors and place them like this, right on the tops of the placeholder blocks and the logs. We're gonna get rid of our placeholder blocks. Then we're gonna take our campfires, place it on top of this log. We're gonna go all the way back until it hits the house. We wanna make sure that these campfires are one block under this roof. And we're just gonna fill in this entire area with these campfires. Once we put all the campfires in, we're going to obviously put them out with our shovel. And once you're done, it should look like this. Our last step until we go to the interior of the base is put some stripped oak logs into the walls mixed in with the oak planks randomly. You don't have to do this, but I recommend it because texturing the walls make it look so much better and just so much more detailed. All right, now that we're done texturing, we're going to make one last finishing touch on the balcony. We're gonna take our lecterns and make a little railing. So we're gonna go to this area right here, right next to the stairs, and place 3 lecterns facing this way. Then we're gonna go to our left and place 3 more lecterns facing this way. And then we're going to take our spruce trap doors and place them right on top of these. Alright, so for our first step, we are going to go to our 2x2 door. And we're going to break those two blocks at the top and place some upside down stairs like this. We're also going to look to our left, look to this door, and we're going to place an upside down stair facing us like this. Next, we're going to take spruce trap doors, go on the inside of the 2x2 door, and we're just going to place spruce trap doors right behind the stairs we just placed, and some spruce doors like this. These spruce trap doors and these spruce doors should be flush with each other, but we'll turn our attention to the left and we'll go inside and place the door right on the log block. Now we will focus on the kitchen area inside here on the left door. Once we enter this area right here to our left, we are going to take our spruce slabs and place it right here along the spruce log block on the top. We're going to place a beam of spruce slabs, skip one, place a beam of spruce slabs, skip one, and spruce slabs. In these gaps, we're going to place our spruce trap doors facing this way, like this. Alright, so now we are going to take our cauldron, and then we're going to place it right in the middle like this. We're also going to take our water bucket, place some water inside, take a crafting table, place it to the left of the cauldron, and then a smoker to the right. Next, we'll make a little shelving unit, so we'll put some barrels right above this 2x1 window, and then we'll take spruce trapdoors and place them right under the barrels to get a little shelving unit. Next, we will take a lantern and place it right on top of the crafting table just to give us some more light. We're going to turn to our backside, and we're going to take a blast furnace, place it right in the middle, and then 2 furnaces right next to each other. We're also going to mirror this side with the shelving unit. We're going to take barrels, place them right on top, and then spruce trap doors on the bottom. We're also going to put a lantern right on this furnace, just to give us some more light. So for our seating area, we're going to take our spruce stairs, place it facing like this. We're also going to take our spruce trap door, place it right in front of the stair, and place a spruce sign right next to the stair. Next, we're going to take a spruce slab, place it right above the trap door we just placed, and place a lantern right on top, just for some more lighting. Now, to finish it off, we're going to take some red carpet and just place it right in this little cauldron area right here. For our last little decoration piece, we're going to take a composter, place it right here along the logs, and then place two spruce leaves. Now we will exit this area and go into our bedroom area. So for our bedroom, we are going to go up to this 3x3 area we have here, and we're going to place spruce slabs along like this. Skip one and then place spruce slabs like this. In the gap, we're going to put trap doors just like we did in the kitchen, like so. And then we are going to go move on to this taller tower side. So I'm just going to place a lantern right here so we can see, but we will go all the way up and to our spruce log little band area we have here. We're gonna go one under it and place our spruce slabs like this. We're gonna skip a block and then we're gonna place more spruce slabs, and in the gap we'll place our trap doors. Next, we will take our composter and our spruce leaves. We'll place it right next to the door and place two spruce leaves at the top. For our bedroom, we're going to place a red bed or whatever bed you have available right in the middle. We're also going to place a spruce trap door at the end. Next, we're going to take a chest and place it to the left, a bookshelf placed to the right, flower pot on top of the bookshelf, and a pop. We're also going to put a light, so we're going to go above and place a slab right above the bed, and we're going to take a lantern and place it right on there. Next, we're going to make another seating area, so we're going to take our spruce stairs and place it in the corner like this, take another sign, place it right next to it, and a spruce trap door. We're also going to place a lantern right above on this log, just for some more lighting. And we're going to go right above the door, and we're going to put a slab right there, and a lantern. Now we are going to take some barrels and place it right under the lantern you just placed, placing trapdoors right under these barrels. We're also going to place some more barrels right in the other side, and place some spruce trapdoors like this, so you have more storage at the top. Now to finish it off, we're going to take some paintings and place them one right above the seating area. Nice little angel right there. We're also going to place one right next to the little plant we have here. Maybe a one block one. Yeah, we'll do that. And then we'll also place another one block one right here. Now to finish it off, we're going to take our red carpet and just place a red carpet line right here. Alright guys, hopefully you guys enjoyed this new style tutorial video. If you guys want to see more tutorials, make sure to comment that down below and like and subscribe to the channel. With that being said, see you guys in the next one.